morning, everyone. My name is Fuad, as you already know. And I'm going to talk about a little bit about Chinese presence in the source Caucasus. Because in the case of the source Caucasus, there's not that much Chinese soft power. And since my topic is excessively focused on Azerbaijan, I'm going to talk about China and Azerbaijan cooperation in different fields, which mostly consist of economic cooperation and some cultural cooperation, and mainly Azerbaijan and Chinese cooperation consists of different international transit, international trade routes and transit corridors. Compared to different regional countries like Russia, Turkey, and Iran, or different countries, China historically is not really engaged with the South Caucasus, and it has fairly very limited historical experience with the South Caucasus. Because if go back to the history, you have all you have the Ottomans, you have the Russian Empire, and then you have like Iran, which has always been a very active regional actor in this region. Chinese presence in the South Caucasus can be dated like maximum for 10 or 15 years ago. And China's main interest in the South Caucasus, of course, can be explained by not only by rich hydrocarbon resources. It also can mostly be explained by the very geostrategical location of the South Caucasus, and in this sense, the geography matters for China. And geostrategic location between the South Caucasus is literally is a gateway between Asia and Europe. So most of you know the political map. So you can just imagine that how the South Caucasus being in the middle of Asia and the Eastern Europe is perfectly match the interests of China and Chinese foreign policy agenda. And China seeks such a position on the world stage in which it can be isolated from the both from the international community and from regional communities like in the South Caucasus or Central Asia or Southeast Asia and different places. So, therefore, relations between China and the regional countries are mostly based on mutual beneficial conditions, which are the main goals of the Chinese foreign policy, and definitely it seeks an opportunity to even more boost its presence in that region. So, also. While talking about China in the South Caucasus, one should exactly notice the presence of Russia, which sees the South Caucasus as its geopolitical backyard, and the South Caucasus is definitely a very important region for Russian interest, because of Iran, because of Turkey, and because of being at the roots of Central Asia and because of the Caspian Basin. So therefore China tried to avoid some ambitious actions towards the South Caucasus in order not to anger Russia and in order to avoid some misunderstanding between Moscow and Beijing, which is of course a very important issue for them. As my colleague already told about this One Belt One Road initiative, which now they call Belt and Road Initiative, it also includes the South Caucasus region, mainly Azerbaijan and Georgia, as the most suitable transit ports for Chinese projects, for Chinese international transit route projects. In 2013. The program was officially unveiled during President Xi Jinping's official visit to Kazakhstan and Indonesia. when they call that the China is going to link Asia with Europe and will create a new transit route for all countries, which that will enable all countries to to make a better infrastructure projects, will ease some connections and will help all countries to bolster their own trades, and, trade turnovers and everything else. The initial focus, of course, has been made on by building infrastructure, highways, bridges, and ports, seaports, and China has heavily tried to to bring some investments to the South Caucasus countries like to Azerbaijan, to Georgia, to Armenia, and just to ease the linkage between between those two regions. And the BRI initiative gives the regional countries an opportunity to expand their relations with different parts of the world, the different countries, and the Belt and Road Initiative is supposed to bring some some Balkan countries, Eastern European countries, and some even Baltic states to link between Azerbaijan and China and Central Asia. of course, like the 10 years ago, officially the Chinese and the Azerbaijan cooperation between Azerbaijan and China officially has been began in 2002. And, 2002, but it was not that significant trade agreement between Azerbaijan and China because at that time Azerbaijan has a very very little vision about China, and the same was about China, which has very less engagement with the former Soviet countries because at that time the Central Asia was the priority of the foreign policy. And the South Caucasus was just beyond the South Central Asia and was like too far for Chinese interest. but since 2002, according to the most recent data provided by the Ministry of Economic Economic Development of Azerbaijan, the China-Azerbaijan trade turnover has reached like $1.8 billion as of 2016. And has been rising at a rate about 15% per annum, which is also not a very significant number compared to Central Asian countries and compared to some Southeast Asian countries like Pakistan and Afghanistan. But the Chinese investments and in Azerbaijan since 2002 reached like $300 million, and. compared to different countries like Turkey, Russia, and Iran, or the EU, the companies from these countries are historically been based in Azerbaijan, and so the Chinese companies just are not able to compete with these countries because Turkey is being a natural ally for Azerbaijan, is one of the biggest trade partners. It's also you have Russia, which is the main. One of the main trade partners for Azerbaijan, and then Iran also linked with Azerbaijan with some railways, highways, and sharing border, quite a long border with Azerbaijan. So for that reason, Chinese companies prefer to to focus on less competitive fields, like development of infrastructure, local infrastructure, upgrading the local infrastructure, building onshore fields in the oil fields, and the modernization of Soviet era hydroelectric power plants. One of them was modernized in 2014 in the city of Mingechevir, which is one of the biggest cities in Azerbaijan, and which historically has been the industrial center of Azerbaijan during the Soviet times and during the modern history of Azerbaijan. Mingechevir has been placed for different plants and the different projects, industrial projects of the Soviet times. And in 2014, Chinese company just agreed to modernize this Soviet era hydroelectric power plant in Ingetur. So the company Triumph International Engineering of China is just they got an agreement with the government of Azerbaijan to make some to upgrade some other infrastructural entities in different cities, like, in addition to Mingechev. So and that was the first time when one of the biggest Chinese construction companies just was engaged in some construction issues in Azerbaijan. And another significant target for China was to build up a Kızıldaş cement plant, which is located in the suburbs of Baku, and which has also been modernized in 2014 by those Chinese company. So for China, in fact, China, Azerbaijan is one of the most potential markets, because it's an economically wealthy country. It has an access to the Caspian Basin. It has quite a lot of hydrocarbon resources, and it has a very geostrategic location because of its seaports and everything. So, and it's the most populated regional country, is 9.5 million people. The second most potential market for China is, of course, Georgia, also because of its location and because of its seaports in Anakli, Batumi, and so on. So Georgia's bilateral trade with China has reached $640 million in 2016, the least competitive market. Relations with China has reached historical rise, attaining like $600 million by 2016. And China mainly imports from Armenia the iron ore for industrial purpose. So, and China's invested $220 million in the construction of synthetic rubber plant with annual income of $100 million. So, and in Armenia, China mainly focuses on also some by providing Armenia with some city transport, helping them to boost some the modernization of city infrastructure, and providing some ambulances, cars, bus, and trains for the common use. So, but the Armenian economy still largely remains very marginal for China. And China prefers, as I mentioned before, China prefers to focus on its international projects, which are the most essential one for China, because they invested heavily to this to these projects, and these regional countries are also interested in attaining some more investment from China, because when in 2015, when energy markets collapse and the prices go down, Azerbaijan and Georgia try to boost some infrastructure projects in order to become a transit hub for big countries like China, and making it rich for China with Central Asian countries and with Eastern Europe countries. And here you see some kind of projects of China. In Georgia, China built Olympic City in the city, Olympic Village, and UCC Plaza, which also been built by Chinese companies. And Chinese energy giant Sinopec, which is the main deals with oil and natural gas issues, has got some stakes in Kian Golbustan onshore fields, which is the only onshore field oil field in Azerbaijan. And they signed an agreement with Azerbaijan company Sokar to get some stakes, and more than $250 million. And China led Asian Infrastructure Bank in 2016 extended a $600 million loan for the construction of Trans-Caspian natural gas pipeline, as you know, the TANAP, which was inaugurated officially in 2017, which is one of the most geostrategically important pipeline and energy project for regional countries. And officially, the Belt and Road Initiative first has been praised by local governments in 2017 during the Davos Forum, when President Ilham Aliyev and now the former Prime Minister of Georgia, Georgi Kvirikashvili, attended the Davos Forum at the same panel, and they publicly praised this initiative, the project, and its perspective for the South Caucasus, because Azerbaijan and Georgia were really looking forward to get some more investments of China in different countries, because now Azerbaijan now is tries to emphasize its role as a transit hub because of geographical location between the Caspian Basin and China-led projects would make the South Caucasus become the main transit hub because of those added international seaport, which became one of the biggest seaports projects in the region, and because of Georgian force in the Black Sea, which are also a significant, play a significant role for China and Azerbaijan. But of course, the main priority project for China is Trans-Caspian International Transit Corridor, which passes through Azerbaijan and Georgia, and linking these countries and Central Asian countries with the Eastern Europe very easily. And this the passes through a corridor of 6,500 kilometer links through Kurik port in Kazakhstan in the Caspian Sea, and links it with Alat port in Baku. The second prospective project for China is a Persian Gulf and Black Sea multimodal transport route, which passes through Iran, Armenia, and Georgia. But this project's perspective is a bit under question because of there's no Iran-Armenia railway link, Iran-Armenia railway that links two countries, and the only railway system, connecting Iran and Armenia was passing through Nakhchivan, Autonomous Republic inside of Azerbaijan. But since the 90s, due to the conflict between Armenia and Azerbaijan, those Nakhchivan road, of course, it's closed, and now Armenia needs a new railway link between Iran and its own territories. But here comes a new problem that Armenia has no financial means to implement this very expensive project, and Iran is also for now, it's not available to implement this process because of the new sanctions, because of the huge inflation now is going on inside of the country. So the only option for this project can be funding from China, and China has not officially been confirmed that it's really willing to fund this project. In order to avoid some diplomatic scandal with Azerbaijan, by providing a direct loan to Armenia, so therefore this project just was put on hold still, because the priority was being declared the Trans-Caspian trade route, which is the most perspective one. And in very near future, they're going to increase the number of freights coming from China and going to the Eastern Europe. So here you see the route of Trans-Caspian International Route coming from Chinese Xinjiang province and passing through Kazakhstan and then going directly to the Caspian Sea, and then through Alat port and Georgia and Turkey it goes directly to Balkan states and Eastern European countries. And in the future, they plan to expand the route until to the Baltic states, to cover some Baltic states as well. and because they also expressed the interest in Lithuania and Estonia as well, really willing to join this route. But still, as I told before, China has really, Chinese investments in this region are not really significant, especially in case of Azerbaijan. And the trade turnover and logistic project China, and China is not the main trade partner for the South Caucasus. In fact, according to data, the European Union is the main trade partner for Azerbaijan, even not Russia, not Turkey, but the main export of Azerbaijan is going to the EU, which is mostly energy-related products. It's oil and natural gas, which makes the EU the main trade partner for Azerbaijan. And Georgia, it's being a transit for those pipelines and for transit natural gas for Azerbaijan. While Armenia is the main trade partner of Russia, according to data, because of being a member of CSTO and the Eurasian Economic Union, it's economically more dependent on Russia and on Russian loans that it receives annually. So therefore, China seeks new ways to get an easy access to the rich EU market, which can be done through the good relations with the South Caucasus countries, and it will make the Chinese attempts and efforts to be implemented very easily if you have a good relations with the South Caucasus. So, and at least the South Caucasus countries need the Chinese presence as a counterbalance for the Russian presence. We know that in the last 4 and 5 years, there's a very growing Russian influence in the South Caucasus. Russia recently increased its number of troops in the North Caucasus, and it increased the number of Caspian fleet in the Caspian Sea. So those countries feel some threat coming from Russia, and the Chinese presence, also the strong EU presence, and it can make some balance between Moscow, Beijing, and Brussels. In case of economic, there's like military partnership, which is also a very less one. Unlike Russia and Turkey, China does not have direct military partnership with those countries. And in case of Azerbaijan, they have inked new agreement in 2018. As you see on the photo, the defense minister of Azerbaijan visiting Beijing. And Georgia-China relations are mainly based on economic issues, because Georgia is mainly set a target to engage with NATO and with the Euro-Atlantic institutions. And Armenia has also military partnership dialogue, which was signed in 2012, and they renewed in 2017. So in 1999, Armenia was the first former Soviet country that received the Chinese multiple launch rocket system, Norinka 80. So and then when the relations with Azerbaijan was just a bit strained because of this, the China stopped the export of weapons to Armenia and everything. And Georgia has not yet shown a great willingness to deepen the military cooperation with China. And until 2008, Azerbaijan has also not direct engagement with China, as for cadets from Polish Academy and Military Academy going to study in Chinese military academies each year. And Chinese companies started to attend the annual military exhibition in Baku in 2016, ADEX, they call ADEX. And according to documents, Azerbaijan secured 915,000 military loan, and in 2014 it secured for $400,000 cost military loan from China. And yet, of course, some military Chinese companies have tried to import to export their jointly produced weapons. It's like the JF-17 Thunder aircraft, jointly produced by Pakistan and China. And Azerbaijan expressed its interest in exporting this weapon, this aircraft, but still no official action has been done. But in 2018, Azerbaijan imported the new Polonis multiple rocket launch system, which also jointly developed by Belarus and Chinese military company. And yeah, in the photo you see the President Aliyev inspecting the new military base, and you see those in the background of Polonis system. And it shows that Azerbaijan, even if it's not directly, it's somehow very closely engaged with some Chinese companies as well. So I'm going to finish here, and you're welcome for your questions.